Despite what you might have seen on Top Gear, Reliant Robins aren't death traps, and this little stunt was staged by monkeying around with the differential. But cars with only three wheels seem less safe. Surely it makes sense to put a wheel on each corner of the car. So, is it possible to build a three-wheeler that's safe? Since the beginning of car design, we've had three-wheelers. In fact, what many consider the first car ever made, the Benz Motorwagen, was a three-wheeler with a single front wheel purely to make the steering simpler. Since then, three-wheel designs either have the front wheel at the front or the back, but there have been the occasional oddities like the Scott sociable from the 1920s, a car dreamt up after thinking about motorcycles and sidecars, but ended up as essentially a car with a front wheel missing and which fell over when driven round a bend. It's been popular to make three-wheelers with a single wheel at the front, and in the middle, of course. It's cheaper to manufacture, with potentially lower maintenance costs, and in some countries, like the UK, you only need a motorcycle license to drive one. It's the backbone of transport in some countries. But there's an inherent instability to this design that's not present in four-wheeled cars. It's something that came into painful focus in the 1980s when three-wheeled ATVs were banned in the US after reports of their instability. It's true that they could be tricky around corners, but by counterbalancing the corner with your weight, they could be safe to operate. Like many things, knowing how to operate it safely and knowing its limits made it safe to use. But many just didn't know this, especially children who didn't have the body weight to counterbalance it through a corner. One of the main worries for three-wheelers is preventing a rollover when going into a bend too fast and slamming on the brakes. This puts a downward force on the front of the car, and if there's just one wheel at the front, it's taking all the load. Couple this with a high centre of gravity, you can see why unskilled three-wheeled ATV riders were involved in so many crashes. Another problem with three-wheelers with a single wheel at the front is their natural tendency to oversteer. A novice driver's first reaction when getting into trouble on a fast bend is to take their foot off the accelerator, and for a car that oversteers, that's bad news. Now, a good chassis designer can find ways of mitigating these problems, but many car designers today are ditching the cost benefits of a wheel up front and putting the single wheel at the back, especially as simpler electric vehicle drivetrains make either setup basically the same price. It's easier to make a car with two wheels up front understeer rather than oversteer, and that makes them much easier for novice drivers to handle in an emergency. And when going into a bend too fast and braking hard, one of the two wheels is now at the corner of the car, which makes it much harder to roll. Some designs even tilt like a motorcycle to make them handle better than cars with four wheels. When you factor in the lower weight and better aerodynamics, it's possible to design a three-wheeler that can beat a four-wheeler around a racetrack. Or at least that was the goal when Nissan created the Delta Wing in 2012. Admittedly, it's got four wheels, but with the front two wheels so close together, it shares a lot of the stability issues of a three-wheeler. But it managed to battle with the big boys in the Le Mans 24-hour race without falling over. One thing you don't see, of course, is a three-wheeled SUV. To make them stable, three-wheelers are often designed with a low center of gravity. That's good for handling and helps prevent rollovers, but it makes it hard to be seen on the road. So, are three-wheelers dangerous? Well, it depends on what you consider dangerous. All cars are dangerous, and cars from 50 years ago were even more dangerous. All cars, including three-wheelers, have to pass safety testing, including the infamous Moose test. And if they don't pass these tests, you can be sure car magazines will point it out. Just ask Mercedes-Benz after the A-Class debacle. Three-wheelers provide less protection from a crash than, say, a large SUV would, but there are some four-wheeled tin cans that don't give a lot of protection either. But with three-wheeled sports cars being low to the ground, maybe the danger isn't coming from rollovers on fast country lanes, but from collisions in city traffic from not being seen. Ava Hookinson proved that three-wheelers were no slouch when she set a 240-mile-an-hour world speed record in one in 2014. What's more, it was electric. It might be fast, but I wouldn't like to be in it when it turned left.